Hi, my name is Maya. I'm a grade 12 student in visual arts. And tonight I'm going to be talking about the process of creating my piece, A Coffee Shop on a Border. In the fall of grade 11, I began to feel very overwhelmed with complex global conflicts and issues that I was learning about, feeling like there was so much to know and I could not possibly understand everything. I felt that this was a negative way to be thinking about the world and wanted to change it. This feeling manifested itself in different situations I found myself in. I would feel frustrated with wonder at a situation or beauty with a certain place and started to blame this on the way my thinking about art has changed and developed over the past 4 years, causing me to overanalyze these situations. I also felt that making art was not coming naturally to me, and although I had a lot of ideas, nothing came together. I met with Mr. Berry in the fall when I was in grade 11 and told him how I was feeling. After talking with him for a while, he ripped off a piece of paper, some sort of flyer that was taped to a door in the school, and wrote down all my ideas that I currently had, laying out for me what I had to work with. This helped me a lot to keep going. I realized my problem was not accepting my developing thought process as a part of who I was becoming. I took a step back from producing art and instead began analyzing the different times when I had felt this way, and began to notice the patterns between them. I realized that the way in which these moments of frustration were connected was either that they happened in a space I found moving and beautiful, such as the desert, or when I found myself in the midst of a complex situation or just learned about an issue I could not grasp. For example, some of these moments occurred while driving near Israel's border with the West Bank, where I was opened up to a whole new discourse about Israel, and also was affected by Israel's size, because it is so small. Wherever you are very close to the neighboring countries, which heightened my awareness of the borders around me. On road trips throughout the United States, traveling across different states and near the US and Mexico border, I thought a lot about the beautiful places where borders often lie. I began to think about the notion of separation between two places and the extreme aspects of differentiation on both sides that cause barriers. I was also inspired by spaces in which people were made to interact with each other, one of which being a coffee shop. It was the possibility of having unexpected interactions with strangers, where despite unforeseen circumstances that brought you both to the same place at the same time, that really moved me. Engaging in an enlightening conversation with another individual that was made possible by the nature of the space we were in, I began to realize the connections and similarities one can share with people from entirely different backgrounds, and how much you can learn from each other. Each of these moments left me with something that caused me to reflect on the interaction long after it happened. I began to understand that each experience I had both inspired me and gave me more substance and knowledge within my everyday life and my artistic practice. In this moment of clarity, I realized that it is okay not to understand everything about the world at once, because every conflict, issue, and change is multifaceted and complex. I also came to the realization that inspiration can come and should come from everywhere and form differently for every individual. With this newfound clarity, I began to create art again, by expressing myself through the places where I felt most inspired by and accepting that I cannot possibly know and understand everything. I began to create work stemming from knowledge I already had. I embraced the things that made me think, which at the time were desert, conversations, borders, and architecture. From these inspirations, I designed and built my piece titled A Coffee Shop on a Border. A coffee shop on a border is a small pop-up coffee shop that is visually divided with a red line that cuts through the center, representing a conceptual border. This piece is supposed to bring two people together who come from very different backgrounds but are still able to talk and learn from one another. The piece is set in the middle of the desert, employing the places where I feel most connected to. It is meant to be a place for conversation and open communication, but the red line remains a strong presence and ultimately forces the coffee drinkers to return to where they came from after they finish. When I was forming the idea of the coffee shop, it was very important to me that when you walked in, you were put into the narrative I was creating. So before I started to make any of the initial drawings and only had a vague image of what it would look like, I wrote a narrative for the piece. The narrative helped me bring the idea to life and got me thinking about the actual things I would need to include in the coffee shop to create the story I was trying to tell. Some of the images that came to mind when writing and stuck until the finished piece was the fan because of the desert heat and the table with the red line cutting across it. Another important part of the process of creating the coffee shop was simplifying. I wanted to get my idea across as clearly and honestly as possible, and this was only through including what was absolutely necessary, which was very difficult. Every part of the coffee shop was either there for a conceptual reason or simply a logical component to make it actually function. At the end, I could explain every single part of the coffee shop down to the tiniest details, which gave myself a lot of clarity and a thorough understanding of my piece. This piece allowed me to work with my growing interest for spatial design and architecture, as well as the importance I found in conversations and open communication. This project also helped me come to terms with the fact that I will not always be able to fully understand each and every conflict or every person's side of the story, but that learning and understanding is an ongoing process. It also showed me that making art is not a singular process, for not only did my inspirations come from other people, but also the finished product would not have been nearly possible without the help of others. After finishing the coffee shop, my inspirations began to shift to different concepts, but what remained was no longer dreading, but appreciating and embracing the way I overthink certain experiences.